Hello, it is the 30th of December 2010, and I recently stumbled across a video which was talking about $35 per ounce silver and the comparison within silver and oil. And I'm not going to link the video or say much more about it other than if you want to find it, if it's still available on the internet or on YouTube. The YouTube search for $35 silver should bring you the result. Anyway, the video was talking about the comparison within silver and oil, as well as a possible market top at 35. Now, I'll talk about that 35 later on. For now, I'm going to talk about the USO and SLV comparison, because in that video, they were talking about how eerily comparable the silver and oil rallies were. Silver up 240% and oil up 280% from their significant lows. So I pulled up some data, and well, the similarities, I personally don't see them in this chart. USO has gained under 200% before rolling over from its lows of $42.56 on January the 18th, 2007, it was a span of 373 trading days, topping at 119.17. I don't got the date for the top, but it's the summer, I think around July the 12th-ish or so of 2008. And therefore, that's 180%. So that's like a carrying the one mistake. I do that a lot too. Silver has gained over 250% from its 845 low on October the 28th, 2010. Thus far, it has closed December the 29th at 546 trading days, reaching 29.99. So not only were the percentage moves a little off, but so was the time duration. I guess the big difference is right in here. Oil was not able to hold this level and did not go higher, where silver stayed consolidating and, well, it obviously went higher. But overall, I don't know how productive it is to compare silver with oil. And if you want to compare against other charts, you know, I'd rather compare the similarities with like 10, 20, 30 different charts that were the same, but you know, I'm not a big fan of that. But I did actually compare silver's rally with another one that was quite similar, and the rally is that of Apple, AAPL, a stock on the NASDAQ. And the markets back at the start of the decade had what was called a dot-com bust, the NASDAQ bubble, if you will. See the NASDAQ fall from 5,000 on the index down about 70 plus percent to around 1,000 something. And the market's bottom in 2003. Apple, April 17th, 2003. And that's when Apple was $6.36. Very, very low. And well, silver bottomed on October 24, 08. The SLV, or the silver fixings bottom, was $8.46. And within the first 280-ish or so days of the bottom, then the market comparisons were very similar. Nice run up here, consolidation period, another run up higher, a breakout period in here, consolidation, higher high, consolidation. It's freakingly similar. But we're comparing Apple with silver. It just can't stay this way, at least could it? And I guess not really, because what happened was Apple went parabolic and, well, silver didn't. I mean, silver's only done better than double its value. And that's not too much in my mind. After all, we've seen how the prices adjusted for inflation are still at fire sale levels right now in silver. But the big difference here, this is where the last chart stopped, is right in here. The difference is how after this consolidation period and this consolidation period, Apple started to make the big gains, where Silver continued to consolidate some more, and will consolidate for a long, long time. And that's fine within the markets. And what it does within a consolidation period is it gives the market some breath or some energy to make the big gains. And when you look at the small amount of gains within this consolidation, it didn't take too much energy for this to happen, meaning it would be very possible or not a surprise to have big gains seeing silver going $50, $60, $70 an ounce because of how long it consolidated for. And this was over a 500% gain for Apple. Now, I'm not going to say that, well, because Apple's gained 500 and silver's got 200, that it's got to catch up to it, so therefore it has to rally. No, not really, other than the reasoning of why markets correct through time is valid enough to make big gains, as well as just because something looks like it's up too much, that doesn't mean it cannot continue to proceed towards the upside, because this thing was $38.89. And if anyone here trades Apple or at least knows where Apple is currently on the stock market, well, here's where it is. It closed the 29th of December at $325 per share. That's 5,000% of an increase from its lows less than a decade ago. Now, obviously, if silver makes 5,000% on $8, that's just going to get extreme. Don't want to say that's going to happen, but once again, just saying that there's really no such thing as up too much if people are still able or willing to buy and there's still a lack of sellers within the markets. And well, now we're looking at the quarterly candlestick chart for silver going back to 1967. And what's interesting is the comparison within the 1970s and now. After all, I'd rather compare silver with silver. And now we're going to compare, I've done this before, I'll do it again, compare the 1970s with the current rally. So within this rally in here, the similarities are going to be a little different than it is now, because it really went up over a 2 or so year period, 2.5 year period, without much of a time consolidation. Its level of gain or increase was from under a dollar and a half to around 6.5, which is over 300%. So a very a little nice gain in here. So this level would be comparable to the areas of from here to here. Now, obviously, there were some price corrections along the way, and the duration in which it went up was a little different. The gain was from about $4 up to about $16, so roughly around the same gain. Now, back in the 1970s, what happened was it consolidated through time for about a half a decade. Here, it consolidated through time for roughly 3 years or so. So you had the run higher, the time consolidation, and then that led us to the breakout. And we've now really just started this breakout. So by saying that this is up too much is like saying it's up too much here when silver was $9 an ounce on its way to 50. Just because a chart looks like it's up too much, that doesn't mean that it is. And if you go by a theory of, you know, I'm going to wait to make sure it's got an all-time high for the day, week, month, year. Well, by drawing a straight line on here, and taking this level from in here, we'll just try to match it up as perfect as I can. Then the second that it broke this resistance was saying it was time to sell. and quite frankly, that never worked out so well. And maybe you can use Fibonacci instead, but even Fibonacci is not always going to give you the answers, because what you would do is you would take the value of this range and multiply 161.8% to the bottom, which meant, okay, sell some around here. And well, once again, that didn't work out either. So a lot of times picking tops and bottoms, it's really a fool's game for the most part. I think Fibonacci overall can do fairly well, but even like I said, because if a resistance point is not resistance, then I would expect major breakouts. And therefore, the Fibonacci I've been using is the level from this low and this high, the $4 to $8 range, which was resistance here, which was resistance here, and now it's resistance here. It's $31.40. So if you want to use a guessing game to pick a top, I wouldn't wait till 35. I would just do it now, because we're at the key Fibonacci level. However, I don't trust this to be a significant resistance point, because what I've been doing is comparing the breakout of 1979 with the current breakout that started back in August of this year. And thus far, this is what's coming up. We got silver on the 15th of January, 1979, for 1 year has gone up from $6 to $50 an ounce. And it already occurred as it was up over 300% from the 72 lows of around $1.50. As I was mentioning, it had two major increases in the 70s, and we're now looking at the second one here. As today, the silver rally from the 18 breakout level is up only under 100%, after it's already up about 300% from the earlier part of the century. And well, thus far, with this being the current silver rally, it's overperformed what silver did back then. But as you can see, it's got a long, long ways to go before it gets to its 1979 levels, if it even gets to those levels, and maybe it'll even surpass those levels. After all, it's pretty much all a guessing game anyway. Use the best information that you can to make it an educated guess, and thus I've been using the educated guess based on the money printing, based on the 1980s and 1990s price manipulation for the price being suppressed, that it's got a long ways to go to the upside. Now, whether it will top out here at 600% gain or 400% or 1500%, I don't know, obviously, but I do see a lot of legs for the silver market to go higher. Thank you for watching this video, and have yourself a magnificent day, everyone. Bye-bye.